She's a Mona Lisa. Everyone's lining up to see her. Hey everybody, today I am cutting the neon soap from yesterday, and the name that I picked out of all of your suggestions was Rainbow Bright. It was the name I saw the most in the comments, and it was actually the name that I first thought of when I saw the soap, but I didn't know if the connection would be made for everybody else, so I was really happy to see that it was a highly suggested name. I also wanted to let you guys know that I am cutting off custom orders for the remainder of the year because I've gotten so many that I need to cap them eventually. So if you do want a custom order, keep in mind that I do not do custom orders for one or two bars. It needs to be a minimum of at least 6 bars for the time and resources that I have to put into it. And yeah, today is the last day. So if you want one done, please shoot me a message on Etsy and I can give you a quote. And I hope you guys have a great day. Thank you. Bye.
Story time about how my friend in high school tried to sell me to pedophiles. So I was 14, it was my freshman year, and me and this girl, let's call her Elizabeth, had been friends for about 5 years. Elizabeth kept bragging about this 17-year-old boyfriend that went to a different school, and every weekend she would try to get me to come to the movies with them so I could meet him. But my parents were pretty strict, so most weekends they said no. But finally, one weekend they said yes. It was a Friday night, and Elizabeth wanted me to walk to the movie theaters to meet her. My dad said no to that. He drove me instead, and he wanted to make sure that Elizabeth and the boyfriend were waiting outside so he could make sure I was there safely. And it's a good thing he did, because when we pulled up, Elizabeth wasn't with the 17-year-old boyfriend she had showed me. She was standing there with 2 30-year-old men. Like for a part 2.
Guys, this is Naf. This video is actually a perfect example of why I strain my henna paste. So I sell henna cones, and they need to be super smooth for you guys to have the best experience, and this is why I strain it in a stocking. All these particles are left behind, and I want all of that out.
If I had to pick one candy to describe myself, I would pick rainbow laces, because they're fun, kids love them, and they're the life of the party.
Just like you.
Just like me.
In the way of candy, I consider myself classic like a gumball. I'm so sweet, people like to chew me up. And notice the sheen. Just like me. Notice?
If I were a candy, I'd be rock candy. It's sweet and strong.
If I was a candy, I would be a peanut butter, because I'm sweet on the outside and a little nutty on the inside. If I were a candy, I would be a Sour Patch Kid, because I'm sour and sweet.
What you should buy your girlfriend for Christmas from My Small Business. Or any girl that's a friend, to be honest. Coming in at number 1, the Zodiac sweatpants. You could pick their Zodiac sign and their name or any word you want.
The booty sweatpants are super cute. You could pick something like this design, or you could put this on the back too. You could pick the font. I really recommend this for your girlfriend specifically because it says baby girl, and right here you can customize the name on that side. And this is what's on the back of those pants. You could put like your name, her name, anything. Onto airbrush items, you could get this tank top. You can get her a matching set. You could get any color for any of these items, by the way. This one's more of like a luxury sweatpant because it has rhinestones, if you can tell, but you could put your name on it. I also sell it going down the leg. And then I have a matching tube top that you can get with it.
When I first launched my business, even some of my closest friends had nothing to say. They didn't necessarily support me, meaning like or share my content or even ask me how it was going with the brand. They just kind of, you know, stayed silent. And at first I took offense to it, but then I quickly realized it is normal human behavior.
Oh, my Lanta, I'll be packing this $155 sticker order while I try to remain calm. Tag along. First 5 Sunset Mandalas, then 7 Everything Happens for a Reason, then 5 Let All That You Do Be Done in Love, then 5 Blue Feathers, 7 Harry Potters, which is definitely a favorite right now, then 5 She Believed She Could So She Did. Wait, didn't I already show packing the feathers? Anyways, 5 Seahorses, and Musical Notes, and then Minis, which are my favorite. They're so cute and perfect for little spots on your water bottle or laptop. She got 5 of each, I believe. The feather's running low. I have to order more. Anywho, this is the whole order. Amazing. Now fun part, freebies. I'm going to add a magnet, a pin, and a bunch of stickers, a sunflower, minis, of course. And I'm going to pack it into this little pocket I made and put the pin in a baggie and pack it all together. Thank you so much, Diana.
Okay, Natalie, say it with me. We
don't
need
it.
We don't need it.
I want to get it.
Hey guys, this is Henna by Nav, and as you guys can see, that color change means dye release, which means our henna paste is ready. Now I'm just thinning it out. I like to thin it out with tea infused water, and this is me just trying to get rid of the smell because it's so strong and my dad doesn't like it. It's the eucalyptus oil that he doesn't really love, but yeah, so now he's grown into loving it. This is me doing a 5-minute stain test. So if it comes out bright orange, that means your henna paste is ready. And this was a beautiful batch, and I can't wait to send out orders. Part 2 is coming.
Attention artists and art lovers of TikTok. TikTok's new algorithm is heavily share-based, and so it's hard for a lot of artists to get onto the For You page. So if you see this video and you love art or an artist...
Hey, Annabelle!
We're packing your order.
Ka-dunk!
Jelly fruits.
Taki-taki. Taki-taki Roomba.
Packing the most stuff today.
It was fun dipping into your order.
Thanks for shopping at Candy Funhouse.
We just got an order. We just got an order. We just got an order. It will be in the mail soon.
Hi, this is a quick trick for my small business owners out there. It's almost inevitable to not end up with a bunch of small pieces of paper that we don't know what to do with. So here's what I do. I bought this 1-inch flower puncher and made confetti out of the small pieces of paper. That way, I feel like I'm not wasting any materials. And now I have a bunch of confetti for my packaging.
Back in my favorite filming setup, oh my god. To top this, I'm going to start with a spoon design. These are pretty tricky to do because they look different every single time. Oh my gosh. My favorite part is the glitter. This eco-friendly aqua white shimmer glitter is perfect for the top of this soap. Don't you guys like looking at the tops? I think they really bring the soap together and they're really fun to design.
Hey guys, it's Aurora from West Maine, and I got a request from Lily to pack her order on video, so here it is. She ordered a pair of our daily leggings, so here they are. Someone asked if they were see-through, and here I am showing that they're not see-through. They're also extremely soft, and I know you guys will fall in love, so definitely check them out. Then, of course, I add a hang tag and wrap it in tissue paper, and of course, add a sticker. Then I'm adding extra goodies to her order and writing a thank you card for her. I then grab one of my mailer bags and put it in, but I'm super torn between these two designs. Let me know which one I should go with.
Today I'm packing 4 lash-filled pinatas. In the past 24 hours, I've had well over 20 orders for pinatas. So I start by adding all the confetti. I then add sweets, that's optional if you want. Then I start adding the lashes and the accessories. So in this pinata, you do get 6 accessories, 7 lashes, and a glue. And as you can see, the pinata is stuffed to the brim. More confetti, more sweets. I've got to make sure it's filled to the top. I want you to get your money's worth when you purchase from me. Also, it's free shipping, so don't worry about that. Link in bio.
So we all know Charli D'Amelio, one of the best TikTok creator on the app. We also all know she gains almost 1 million followers a day. No, I'm not trying to say give me 1 million in a day. But what I'm trying to say is give me 1 million followers in 2 days, because I'm kinda curious if that's possible.
Here's my favorite TikTok ideas for small businesses. Behind the scenes, where you get your packaging from, your favorite product and why, packaging an order, shipping an order.
Here are business ideas that you can start with almost no cash. Yeah, I said it, no cash. You can sell the personal creations that you make. The crafts and beautiful things that you make can be sold on Etsy and Amazon and anywhere online. You'd be so surprised if people would pay on eBay for some of your work. You can be a content provider on Fiverr, meaning you can do Photoshop for people, you can make logos, do little things to people's websites. You can provide in-home services for people. Dog walking, babysitting, landscaping, snow plowing. If you're great at repairs, you can be a handyman, or you can get paid for your expertise as a consultant within any realm or industry. In my case, I'm a business consultant. You can be any other kind of consultant if that's in your expertise. Now go make that shmoney. Good luck.
He's a Mona Lisa. Everyone's laughing.